This week on What's Good Cape Cod, we talk about the face of Cape Cod for the past 24 years, the coolest barber in town, and a playground for everyone. I'm Sarah Lapsley-Martin.
And I'm Katie Clancy. Welcome back to What's Good Cape Cod, where we show you the Cape through the eyes of a couple of locals.
And every Tuesday, we drop a new video that tells you about a person, place, and thing we think you should know about.
Yes, so our person this week is Wendy Northcross. So she is the outgoing CEO of the Cape Cod Chamber of Commerce. She has been with this organization at the helm for 24 years. And I think that's pretty amazing, actually. She has turned it, so most of the information that I am pulling this from is from the article that was written about her in Cape and Plymouth Business Magazine. It's 24 years is a long time. Okay. So she, during that time has made our chamber one of the top five chambers in the state. So Massachusetts.
Wow, that's amazing accomplishment. Yeah.
Massachusetts is kind of, competitive in everything. They're good at everything. We're good at everything. And she took us up to top five, which is really kind of amazing. And the organization, so the Cape Cod Chamber has actually been around for 100 years, which I did not know. And in the article, she talks about wanting to, by the way, the article is by Carol Dumas. She talked about wanting to take it to that 100th year. And of course, little did she know, she was going to take it right through the pandemic.
Yeah.
Not that she's in a government position, but she's, if people have opinions about Cape Cod, she's got to manage that. That is kind of part of her, existence, yes. that organization. So anyway, I've so respected what she has done to be able to do that, to be able to keep us going and get us up to that level. And the things that the chamber does, you don't even think about it. You think, Chamber of Commerce, networking events for business members and, promote us to tourists. And you think it's just all about tourism, but it's, generational economic issues, transportation, wastewater infrastructure, obviously tourism, and community resiliency. And she's really responded to that. She's brave and bold and just kind of a badass.
Yeah.
But she started.
She's been an amazing face of Cape Cod. Like you said, everything she's accomplished. And then, to help get it through the COVID situation as well.
She was, part of, facilitated the COVID response task force.
Yep.
And I really, really respect about her and what she's done is while she's knee deep, elbows deep in all of this stuff and stuff that can be controversial, masks, travel, what do? We open restaurants? She comes across to me at least as completely apolitical. I could be wrong, but her persona, I don't know about you. Have you ever?
I would agree 100% with you. Yeah. That's how I view her.
She just loves the Cape and is the ultimate advocate. I am glad I'm not trying to follow in her footsteps because those are going to be big shoes to fill.
Yes.
But we just wanted to give Wendy a little love because she has given the Cape so much love and she's been someone that we can all sort of model the way, you and me, Sarah, we're kind of the biggest cheerleaders of this place going.
Agreed.
And she has been a great model in the way that she acknowledges all the wonderful things about the Cape. So thank you, Wendy.
We wish you the best in retirement.
Yes, we do. So that's our person. So moving on to our place, total subject change.
Yeah.
So this is a place, the place that we're going to talk about this week is the Barber's Lounge. Neither Sarah nor I has ever set foot.
No.
And because we have daughters, we probably never will.
Yes.
But it's a barbershop. It's a barbershop, as Liv would say.
Barbershop.
And I first came across them. They caught my eye on Facebook. And I really was kind of drawn by, they have really good video. They take great video of the guys cutting hair. It's mesmerizing.
It's impressive what they do. Obviously we don't get our hair cut like that, but what they can do is amazing.
It is total artists with the very specific tools.
And the lines that they can put and they have to have it. It has to be symmetrical. So you can't mess it up.
I have a question for you, Sarah. Did you, during the pandemic, did you ever cut Marty's hair?
I did not during the pandemic, but I have before, and I don't want to.
It ain't easy, is
No,
it?
no,
No. So I tried to cut marks. It
How'd it go?
was so bad.
I wouldn't trust myself. Like, if he asked me, I'd be like, no. Like,
He gave me the clippers. I'm like, I don't know if this is a good idea. And then I'm like, it didn't come out that bad. And then he looked in the mirror and he was like, oh my God. And he just like shaved it off. It was really bad.
at least he can start fresh.
Yeah, exactly. So, like, I have huge respect for what barbers like. So, when
Agreed.
you and I get our haircut, our stylist can make a mistake and we'll be like, oh, the bangs are a little shorter than I wanted, but like, whatever, I have all this other hair. Like, if they like make a mistake at the barber, like, what do you do? Like, turn it into a design? I don't
Yeah,
know.
maybe, I guess.
I guess. So, but anyway, back to the barber's lunch. We're watching them. We're like, oh, just watching what they do. And it just basically, like, just kind of, it was just an interesting videos for me to watch. Nothing I'll ever need, but kind of fun to watch. And so I follow them. So they're showing up in my social feeds. And then during the pandemic, they did a thing where they just got a bunch of backpacks and school supplies. And we're like, hey, what do you need? Come get it. Bring your kids, pick up what you need for school. And that was it. They didn't make a big deal out of it. They weren't like, look at what we are doing. We are the philanthropists. They were just like, there's a need. We're going to do something. Here we go.
Yep.
And they did it.
That's
And
amazing.
I was like, wow, you guys really kind of are the whole, like, whole enchilada. But like, have you, so when I was preparing for this, I started actually really studying, and they sort of alternate their posts between like, hey, this guy that got this haircut or whatever. But they do these, like, they talk about all the different techniques. There's the burst fade, there's the drop fade, a lineup. Like, they are into it.
I've never
And
heard
don't
these
tell
words.
me, like, this is not like hair styling and product and all that stuff is by no means the domain of the woman. These guys are into it. And then you don't even get me started on the beards.
Oh, agreed, right?
Like, there's a whole artistry around that too. Plus product. They're like, there was a post that they had about like, hey, listen, we know everybody wants to sort of get out of the shower, but it's like, don't skip conditioning. I'm like, preach, never skip conditioning. You gotta condition. Anyway, I just thought that they were just cool. I love their marketing. I love what they're doing. I respect them as artists. And I also noted we need more boy things here. So little nod to the boys there.
Yes.
All right,
Finally.
Sarah, what's our thing this week?
So our thing this week is Luke's love playground. So I did not discover this until Luke was born. But
Why
this
would
is
you?
such an amazing playground. So things that really make it different that I really love is that there's two different play areas. So one for the older kids, one for the younger kids. It's all fenced in, so you don't have to worry about the kids running away too far.
Yep.
They have a whole like drum and music area. They have picnic tables, lots of open space to run around, and the ground is, it's not sand, it's like they call it a poured in place safety surface. It's kind of like got a little bounce to it.
Yep.
But the thing that's really great about this playground is that it is, let's see, where do I start? So I guess
Flexible.
first I'll say that it's a certified boundless playground. And so the mission of these playgrounds is to create structures that can be used by all children, including those with disabilities. And so every inch of the space is wheelchair accessible, which is
Oh.
just a, yeah, it's amazing to have in the community. I mean, there's so many people that need that.
Yeah.
And all kids should be able to play on the playgrounds.
Yeah, and like a wheel, something that is wheelchair accessible is actually accessible to everybody. It doesn't mean that kids
Right.
who can walk can't use either. Run right through, push your friend in a wheelchair, do whatever, like play together.
Exactly. And that they have that surface, the wheelchairs can go easy on it. It's wonderful. So it's this boundless playground, and the playground actually first opened back in 2010. And it was given to the town of Barnstable by the Luke Vincent Powers Foundation as a gift for children with all abilities. And the foundation was formed by Suzanne and Bill Powers back in 2003, unfortunately, after the death of their infant son. So in 2000, their baby boy Luke was tragically taken too soon. And so the family, vowed to make a difference in children's lives in his name. So this is their way of giving back in the name of Luke, which is, amazing that they can see so many children enjoying this place.
Yeah.
And then the thing that was interesting that I learned, so It was open in 2010, but then it was actually moved. So in 2017, West Barnstable's Lombard Field, they were doing a whole like overhaul of it. So yeah. They closed the playground and moved it like 60 yards. And so it reopened. Yeah, this is crazy. So it reopened in 2019, which is probably when I found it because Liv was one. And we've loved it ever since. And another great thing they do for the community. So they've helped other organizations like WIC Families and Cape Kids Meals, which addresses local hunger issues. And we've actually been to, not this past year, but the year before, they had Santa come. So Santa came on a big fire truck. And so all the kids got to go there and they suggested that you bring a donation to the for the baby center in Hyannis.
Yes.
So yeah. It's just a fun thing of like a great way for them to give back, but also a great way for the kids to see Santa. And it was such a fun day and very, you know, get you in the spirit of things.
Yeah. Oh, that's very cool. I love it.
Yeah. So such a nice thing that came out of this, you know, sad, tragic for Luke, but it's so nice that they were able to give back.
A really seriously good gift. Yeah.
Yes.
All right. Well, that was good. But that's it for this episode. So now you know what's good Cape Cod. If you're watching on YouTube, click the subscribe button and the bell to get reminded when we drop a new episode.
And if you're looking for more information about anything we talked about in this video, go to What's Good CC, where we have links to everything we talked about this week.